How does it feel to bring the film specifically to Sundance London?
It's great. I haven't been to Sundance London before, so the film premiered in the real Sundance in America. And obviously this film's a very British film. It's a film set in Soho in London. So it's great to have a chance to show it here.
The film is about one of the most interesting, controversial, flamboyant, infamous characters in this country. What made you specifically want to bring Paul Raymond's life to the big screen?
Well, the starting point was Steve. I mean, Steve Coogan, who plays Paul Raymond, thought that he would be a good character to play. I didn't really know that much about him. I knew the kind of broad strokes of his career. I mean, I think Paul Raymond had a great career. It was spread over 40 years. He started off as an end of the kind of peer entertainer with a kind of cheap mind-reading act. He wasn't very good at that. He wasn't very good at entertaining, so he became a producer and became incredibly rich and successful. So it felt like there's masses of interesting material. It's just how to organise it and shape it into some sort of film.
What was the biggest challenge in crafting those 40 years down into an enjoyable and articulate 2-hour film?
I think it's like trying to balance the stuff, the stuff of his public life, because obviously he was in a way in the entertainment business. That's how he always described himself. So he's trying to balance that with all the kind of music and dancing and naked women, which is all kind of quite fun and on the surface, with his personal life, which was more complicated. We refer in the film to the King Midas story, and in a way his story is kind of very much like that. It's someone who had huge material success but lost a lot of the people who were close to him.
Of course, I mean, Paul Raymond inextricably linked to Britain's attitudes towards sex and pornography. What kind of a legacy do you think he's left in that respect? Is it positive, negative?
That's a very difficult question. I don't know. I mean, I'm sure, different people have different views of that. I suppose for me, I kind of imagine that Paul Raymond, in a way, kind of shows how public taste changed. His kind of barometer of public taste changing. I think his motive was, partly to entertain people. I think he always said that he knew what the average kind of man wanted, and partly to make money. So I don't think he was really a pioneer about pornography is really important, or you must have more sex. It was more like this is an area of entertainment where he could be successful. And so I think he kind of reflects public taste rather than kind of having created it.
Well, alongside Steve, you've got a fantastic female cast. I mean, Imogen Poots playing his daughter, the beautiful Tamsin Egerton. Can you talk a little bit about the leading ladies in Paul's life that we get to see on screen?
Yeah, I mean, I think, if you imagine the world of Paul Raymond, you imagine a world where the women are just kind of there for men to look at them. It's a very, objects for men to look at. So it's great. What's great about the story is that the three strongest characters really are all women. So Anna Freer, Imogen Poots, Tamsin Egerton, they kind of play the three most important women in his life, his wife, his girlfriend, and his daughter. And so, one of the things I liked about the shape of the film was that actually the women in the film are really active and strong.
What's next for you after this?
I'm doing a second series of The Trip with Steve Coogan and Rob Brydon. So we're going to Italy. So Steve and Rob are touring around Italy and eating lots of food.